Ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe that I'm about to say this, but EA has published a good Star Wars game. Nani, I know. Yeah, but I'm thoroughly enjoying Jedi Fallen Order. In large part because, well, it's a proper video game that seeks to entertain. It isn't some monetization machine disguised as a video game. This feels like a game where the creators got quite a bit of freedom to do what they wanted to do to realize the vision they wanted. And the end result is a game that is just genuinely enjoyable, that genuinely makes me feel like a part of the Star Wars world. And it's not perfect, but man, it's got a lot of merits going for it. And man, do I want to keep playing it. So far, I'm like 10 hours in, so I haven't finished the game. I haven't played enough of it to make a full review, but I can give you my impressions. And I guess the best way I can put it is that it takes the combat and progression of Dark Souls, the world navigation and set pieces of Uncharted or Tomb Raider, and the exploration and level design of Metroid Prime, and marries them together into a package that's quite cohesive. And a package that just works. All the pieces, all the gears kind of click together. So combat, it's pretty good overall. It is gonna feel somewhat familiar to those who are used to Soul-style games where you have to be really meticulous about your attacks. You can't just button mash. You have to press every button deliberately. Dodge deliberately, evade and parry deliberately. And combat really gets good once you unlock all your force power. So, you know, force pull, force push, freeze things in place, and all of these different abilities that you unlock over time. Once the game allows you to play with a plethora of tools, then you can really do some cool stuff. But even when you're powerful, even when you do get all these powers, enemies can, with a few good attacks, just wipe you out. So you have to be aware of your surroundings. You cannot just treat this like this is Force Unleashed. You have to memorize enemy patterns and dodge as much as possible, time things appropriately. If you are careless, you'll just get wiped away pretty cleanly. And now I played in the second easiest difficulty, which is the default. And that alone already offers a decent amount of challenge. This game allows you to pick how hardcore you want to make the experience for yourself. If you want to go full out Souls-like, then you can pick the hardest difficulty where your parries, your timing has to be pitch perfect, where you take more damage. So there is some choice there for players. Now, I describe Jedi Fallen Order as a Souls-like, but really the Force powers and the Star Wars coat of paint really does come across quite well, and it is very satisfying to be able to use the Force powers, clean out enemies, to be able to use them creatively, and, you know, being able to deflect laser shots with your lightsaber. You really do feel like a Jedi, and I know that's a whole meme saying it really feels like you're Spider-Man, it feels like you're Jedi, but it's true. The game does a good job of putting you in the shoes of a Jedi. And then there are, of course, boss battles you'll encounter throughout Jedi Fallen Order. And much like the Souls games, they encourage that you really learn enemy patterns and attack at just the right time. And there's some that are big giant creatures or big giant mechs, and then others are sort of your other lightsaber wielders who you face off against. And they're pretty cool. Some of the boss battles against the lightsaber users, those are always like really cool. They feel really cinematic. Now, I do have a couple issues with combat. First of all, when it comes to the timing of parrying and evading, there are times when the timing is wonky, or there are times when I felt like I should have totally parried that or dodged that, but the enemy hit me anyway. And then there are times when camera gets in the way. And then a couple times, there are enemies that pop out of nowhere, like these rat things that unburrow from the ground and attack you, but there's no way to tell that that's gonna happen. So it's just kind of like an unfair way to ambush you. But beyond that, combat feels pretty good. It is familiar, but it also establishes its own identity in the way combat works. You definitely want to keep a close eye on your health. It can deplete pretty quickly. Even in my default difficulty, Health was a valuable commodity that I had to keep an eye out for. And just like in Souls games, you have these health vials that you can consume to recover some of that health, but that's limited. There's only so many of those you have per checkpoint. And also, much like Souls games, there are these meditation points that essentially act like Dark Souls bonfires. That's where you rest, where you recover HP. These meditation points act as checkpoints, so when you die, that's where you return to, so you don't have to go all the way back. And in meditation points is where you level up and learn new skills. And Jedi Fallen Order has an extensive skill tree where every upgrade really feels substantial. There's everything from passive upgrades like increase in force bar max and then increase in health to new lightsaber maneuvers, new force abilities, all of which come in handy, all of which make you feel like your character is really progressing. And progression is, I think, one aspect that this game really nails down. Now, back to the topic of the bonfires or the meditation points. Like in Dark Souls, resting at these checkpoints, resting at the meditation point and recovering your health and recovering your health stims, it'll respawn all enemies in the area, which is exactly the way it works in Souls-likes. Now, when you're not in combat, you'll be exploring these vast open environments. They're not sandboxy. There are a lot of definitely corridors and stuff like that, but they branch out a lot and they interconnect in the way that you would expect from a title like Metroid Prime, which is where this game draws inspiration from for world navigation, and this is something that the developers themselves have admitted. Now, the navigational systems, as I said before, inspired by Uncharted. So you'll be climbing up cliffs, you'll be swinging through ropes, you'll be wall running, and using your force powers to navigate the world. And the force powers adds a unique flair to navigation that separates it from the likes of Uncharted. But you essentially unlock these abilities over time. Wall running isn't readily made available to you from the outset. Double jump isn't something you have from the outset. Certain force powers aren't available from the outset. But as you unlock these, much like in Metroid, where as you unlock Samus's abilities, you get to explore more of the world. The same thing happens in Jedi Fallen Order. The worlds open up more and more. And I say worlds because there's multiple planets in this game that you can travel back and forth between. And you'll visit a planet, you'll do the main quest there, but there are certain areas that are still locked off because you don't have the ability to access those areas to navigate those parts of the world. So you'll maybe go to another planet, do a mission there, and then come back to this planet and find that with new powers that you have, you're suddenly able to explore more of that world, and that kind of loop continues. It's very Metroid Prime 3-esque in that way. I would say that level design isn't quite as elegant as something like Metroid Prime. I felt some of the backtracking in Jedi Fallen Order felt a bit tedious, like shortcuts should have been better thought out. But overall, world traversal is good enough, and the worlds themselves are really well realized. Each planet has its own unique flavor. It's kind of cool to just bask it all in and just experience the fact that you are in a Star Wars setting. And the game also encourages exploration. You can go off the beaten path and find what are called Force Echoes, so you'll find like corpses whose memories you can glean at, or you'll find life essences or force essences, which are like heart pieces from Zelda that if you collect 3 of them will increase your maximum life or your maximum force meter. And then there are certain side ventures like these side puzzles and side dungeons that you can solve to obtain some of these things like echoes and the essences, and you'll also find chests scattered throughout the world, and these chests contain cosmetics that are not locked behind some paywall. You just unlock these cosmetics by playing the game and just finding these loot chests that are gameplay loot chests, not the loot boxes that you have to pay for. It's kind of cool to be able to delve into the crafting table and cosmetically customize your lightsaber and things like your main characters Poncho and BD-1, who's your droid, and also your ship. Now, this isn't some RPG where you'll find side quests everywhere. These side ventures are, there are a couple of them. They're not that many, but there's enough to encourage side exploration. But for the most part, you'll just be doing the main quest. There's also a large emphasis on environmental puzzles, so you'll find these huge dungeons that are very reminiscent of Uncharted or Tomb Raider, but with their own Star Wars flair to them, and you'll be using your force powers to try to solve these giant dungeon-like areas. And those are really cool. They look really cool, and they're really well designed. And while the puzzles are relatively rudimentary, they're good enough that solving them feels satisfying. And all around, these dungeons are really just really cool to behold. And then further keeping me engaged throughout the game, apart from its solid gameplay and exploration elements, apart from its generally fun and satisfying combat, is the story, which I do think needs to be better paced. I am so far invested in it, but a lot of the cutscenes and dialogue revolve around these MacGuffins, and they're constantly explained and extrapolated upon, but I don't really care about learning too deeply about the MacGuffins. I care about the characters. And when the story does start focusing on characters and the core plot points, it does get interesting. It does make me feel like I want to learn more. And I feel like the performances help with that. There's some just great performances all around, especially for the core characters. But at the same time, I haven't seen enough of the story. I haven't played it all the way through to fully determine whether the story pays off. But it is very much that Star Wars fantasy, sci-fi, action-adventure story that you might expect from the series. It's got that lighthearted kind of feel to it, but juxtaposed with some elements of gravity that round things out. Now, where the game is at its most flawed is on a technical level. First of all, the graphics in this game, they look kind of dated. A lot of the character models, the textures, the lighting, they just don't look super impressive compared to some of the other titles that I've seen in recent years. Now, the artistic design of this game really helps bolster all of that. It helps a lot in allowing me to ignore some of the graphical drawbacks, because the art team really did their homework with Star Wars. Every stormtrooper, every environment, the artistic design of the world, to the lightsabers, the minute details there, all of that's just really awesome. And the game does look good during cutscenes. And beyond the artistry of it all, there are some really great set pieces, a la Uncharted, but with that Star Wars flavor, that are really exciting to behold, that are really just well done and well designed. But it's definitely noticeable when you look at a Wookiee and see how hideous those character models are, or even some of the more generic NPCs. And when you get up close and personal with some of the environmental details, a lot of it looks very muddy. And then animations as well, they're janky. Occasionally, you'll definitely find times when animations don't transition properly. And while during cutscenes, the performance capture shines through really well, during gameplay, some of the animations look weird or just kind of skip around a lot. Perhaps the most egregious element of Jedi Fallen Order is its lack of polish. The game's quite buggy and glitchy. Nothing game-breaking, but there's just a lot of stuff in there that completely takes you out of the game. I've talked before about how some of the animations can be janky. Sometimes animations just completely break down. A lot of weird skips. Sometimes I'd get stuck behind objects. Like, there was this one time where Cal automatically walks towards the ship in order to start a cutscene, but because I was behind an object when I approached the ship, Cal just got stuck there for a while, and I had to like button mash to eventually get out of that, and that was bizarre. There are plenty of collision issues. There's one time where I pushed a stormtrooper off a cliff, but they got stuck in between some objects and they stayed there, and stuff like that happened far too frequently than they should have. And then there's the enemy AI. The AI in this game can be pretty freaking dumb. Sometimes you'll see a bunch of enemies attacking, but one stray guy will still be patrolling. Other times you'll be right in front of the enemy and the AI just won't attack. Other times they'll get stuck in these animation loops. Instead of trying to walk around objects, they'll keep walking towards the objects and they'll stay stuck there. And then back to graphics, there are a lot of model and texture popping that are super distracting. And this stuff is consistent. It's not just one or two times, this happened a lot throughout my experience with this game, and I wish the game had a couple months to really flesh all of these elements out so that the experience could just be smooth and continuous. But there's a lot of interruptions, a lot of bizarre things. But with all said and done, when the game's running on all cylinders, when it's really just running smoothly and everything's working as intended, It's just a fun, feel-good, comfort food-style Star Wars video game, which we haven't seen in forever. And so it was so refreshing to play a Star Wars game that I could genuinely enjoy, that was single-player, that felt like an epic adventure where, you know, you and your lightsaber and your force powers were the focus. It just feels really good to play this game. I really like it. It's not some big, great masterpiece, but it is just, again, comfort food. It is just something you sit down, relax, and play. You're challenged by it, but you also have fun. And it's just cool to just explore. It's nice. It's just a nice game to play. And EA needs to publish more games like this. This is the stuff that makes me happy. This is the type of Star Wars experience that we've wanted for years and years now. And yes, it borrows heavily from other franchises. It's not a unique game. You're not going to play something that breaks new ground, per se. But it takes all of these separate elements, puts them together into a cohesive package, and creates a proper, good Star Wars experience that I think a lot of Star Wars fans will thoroughly enjoy. Now, I don't know if Jedi Fallen Order has the potential for a sequel, I haven't finished the story yet, or if this is a one-off type of deal, but whatever system they currently have in place, you know, if they can refine that, if they can take what they've built for Jedi Fallen Order and take it to the next level, polish it up, really flesh out the systems, and really work on the technical elements to refine everything, they could really, you know, much like how Uncharted 1 was rough before Uncharted 2 really blew the series out of the water, something similar could happen with whatever foundation Respawn established here. So hopefully we'll see them make more games like this. So all in all, I'm pretty happy with this game. It is rough around the edges, but man, is it just good times. That's all this game is. It's good times with zero caveats, zero BS. It's just a good Star Wars game. So that's my take on Jedi Fallen Order, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure many of you have played this game. Let me know what your take is on this title in the comments below. With that, I would like to end this first impressions of Jedi Fallen Order. Thank you for tuning in. To be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.